Hey, this is Pamela Schneider. I'm the retail editor for Blue Book Services, and I have Anne-Marie here from 210 Analytics, and we are here to talk about COVID-19 consumer patterns week 9. What did we see on the retail grocery side?
So we're looking at the week ending May 10th, and that, as we all know, was also Mother's Day weekend. So we talked about it last week. Was that going to be big? Was it not? Traditionally, the National Retail Federation talks about Mother's Day as the one single biggest holiday for restaurants. Well, we know that across states, restaurants are either open with social distancing measures in place, maybe 25 capacity, or they're closed altogether. So we had really no idea what this holiday was going to look like in today's world, but it looked good for produce. Good for retail, at least, absolutely. 17% up overall. So we continue to sit in that high teens when we compare this year's sales over the same week last year. And we also continue to see that strength in vegetables up 23% versus about 12% for fruit. So the patterns are really starting to hold. Now, like I said, Mother's Day, without a doubt, had a big influence on that. But it's good to see that we're continuing to sit right in those high teens, and that makes me very hopeful for the summer season coming up.
The one number that continues to shock me is oranges. I mean, yeah. Oranges are tracking over 60% and even pushing 70% year-over-year increase. I would have thought with the domestic season, kind of, you know, the navels aren't as available. We're switching over to Valencias. So we've got some offshore fruit coming in. And I'm just shocked that oranges continue to post such huge gains, because it's not just dollars. It's also volume.
Right. And it's also not a tiny category. And so a lot of times I have to always remind folks that, hey, don't just go for that high percentage growth, because it doesn't always mean anything. If you're a pinprick, you're still a pinprick with enormous growth numbers. But in the case of oranges, that's a sizable category. And to see, to your point, week after week, that number lying between 60 and 70% in both volume and dollars, that's amazing.
It's amazing. And you know, we aren't exactly sure why people are gravitating toward oranges. It could be the immunity boost. It could be the vitamin C thing. Keep reminding people, bell peppers have more vitamin C than an orange. But you don't want to take away from those sales. It's amazing. But I really hope that some of this momentum moves into to the summer fruit season that's coming up. We've got cherries that are starting to hit stores. We've got stone fruit that's starting to hit stores as well. And we have other fruit that is looking, sitting back and going, hey, can I get a little bit of this pie here?
So. Yeah, absolutely. And you know, I think we've talked about this before. The big challenge in fruit is, how do we translate that normal impulse of an eye-catching display of seeing beautiful strawberries, cherries, peaches, whatever it might be? How do we translate that into the current environment? And I would say the role of the produce manager has just amplified, or anybody in the department in retail that just has that enthusiastic personality. You know, I was listening to some retailers last week who said, I got a batch of watermelons in, and it's the best watermelons I've ever had. And then my question is, did you put that on social media? Are you translating the enthusiasm that you had for these watermelons onto your customers so they want to come to your store and they want to go grab one of those watermelons for dinner or snacks or whatever?
There are some amazing examples of retailers that are extremely nimble. I love Steve Morrow at Allen's Foods in Bell Vista, Arkansas. You should look that up on Facebook. They are the best social media I have ever seen, and they're out there with their folks at their appropriate social distance and whatever, just hawking produce in that old farmer's market style way, but within the retail chain. And that's something else we wanted to talk about is, we talked about the impact of food service reopening, perhaps that we're going to see some softening in some of these retail sales numbers. The other kind of elephant in the room is, we're coming up on farmers market season, and are consumers going to trust going to the farmers market as much as, or are they going to be, do farmers markets do click and collect? I don't know. Is that a CSA? How does this work?
Fascinating. Yeah, it's a fascinating topic because not only are we coming up on farmers market seasons, but as we know that over the years, there had been more and had been open longer as well as open multiple days a week. So that sales that was going, especially in produce, the sales that was starting to go through farmers markets was starting to be pretty substantial. And I have not seen in my local town, which normally living in Florida almost goes year round, it's been canceled. I have not seen them come back. I've not seen any notifications on it. And so, you know, we've talked about, are people gravitating more towards packaged? Well, that's not the case in farmers markets. Are people, you know, people want to see very visual food safety measures? You know, are people going to stand in a farmers market with masks, et cetera, on? And is that whole feel then still the same? So, yeah, I think that is another really big something to think about in retail. How can you bring some of those elements into the retail store to still attract those kinds of shoppers who are interested in organic and in local and really that entire atmosphere of a farmer's market and trying to recreate that?
I think, especially with what we've got going on now with farmer direct sales, it's a little bit different than having the events. I've heard of some people going to the farmer's market. I've heard that here in Austin, Texas, they have this tent spread out. Most of our farmer's markets are actually in mall parking lots. Out there on the asphalt, it's a very down homey feel with your soccer mom tent in your parking lot. But so they spread them out. They have limited people to come in. You have to, but my impression of it is you have to be really dedicated to want to go out to one of those. I think we're going to see more occurrences of farmers selling direct to consumers, whether it's a CSA type model, the community supported agriculture, those are probably pretty popular with signups right now. Or we'll even see farmers going more digital because I think more people are trusting that business model if they still have a job, if they still have the income, because that's also a concern with so many people out of work. We're going to see some recessionary spending and perhaps a trip to the farmer's market really doesn't fit in with your budget or lifestyle.
Yeah, and I think the other thing too is another big farmer's market item has always been artisan bread, etc. And we sure know that quarantine baking is a thing. So I've seen your breads. They look fantastic. So if there's multiple reasons for not taking that actual trip, maybe there's fewer items that people are interested in. We know farmers markets were very big for produce. That was often the trip driver for produce. But I think this is actually a great opportunity for some of the distributors to continue to go direct and sort of take over that, as well as for retail to bring in the elements of farmers markets into their store even more than they have in past years.
And actually, while we're on that topic, something that maybe doesn't fit in with my particular audience, but fits in with what you talk about, the one area that I've really seen catch on over the last couple of weeks when we've talked about meat shortages and processors is I've seen a huge upswell and good feelings towards working with local meat producers and smaller meat producers right now because people are concerned about being able to get meat at the store. And so they're turning to local people, local butchers, and local ranchers to fulfill that demand. So I think there's a tremendous opportunity in the meat category there, but maybe produce, we're going to see people going more toward the supermarket.
Yeah, and I wouldn't agree that there's always been a natural synergy between produce and meat. I mean, they're always together on the front page. You're really the two departments that drive store choice. They're the two biggest parameter departments. And I think in that regard, you're absolutely right. There is a renewed appreciation for the small supermarket up the street. And likewise, there's really renewed appreciation for the smaller meat processors, the smaller brands that are, you know, still working and making sure America has meat and poultry and nutritious options available in that regard. And I think that's a huge lesson for produce to not necessarily you know, the whole country of origin, but really talk about that local aspect and show that the importance of people, I guess, is my point. And that's really emerged in the world of meat and certainly in produce as well.
And I think consumers, if you live in an area that is a production region for agriculture, I think people are really in love with the idea of going to the farm and picking up a box at the farm. I mean, what else you got to do? You can't go anywhere else. That part of it, that connection to their food supply chain, I think people are really feeling touchy-feely right now for that and longing for a connection to their supply chain. So I think that really puts an emphasis on local and some opportunities for growers, but also for, you know, retailers to, you know, use some of that content in their social media and make sure that we're building those connections more than ever.
Yeah, fully agree.
All right, well, we will take another look next week, looking for our pre-Memorial Day numbers coming up next week. That's another big holiday that I really think it's going to be out the gate. People are going to be getting together. Everyone's been so conservative. We had no Easter celebration. We had no Mother's Day celebration in a lot of places. I think people are going to be just flocking to get-togethers, and we're going to see that reflected in sales.
Agreed. I'm really curious to see those numbers for the simple reason that there are so many summer holidays, and I think the way we perform in Memorial Day is going to be very telling for the rest of the summer season. So the next couple of weeks, I think, are going to be a crucial indicator for where life is going to take us.
All right. Thanks, Anne-Marie.
Thanks, Pamela.